And actually, I know most of the online sessions are, you know, kind of one way presentations and one way lectures kind of thing. But what we are going to do today may not be kind of one way lecture at all. Okay. So what I will. Hello.
You are audible, sir. You are audible.
Okay. Okay. So what I understand I'll do is we will have some practical first, and then only we will go for, you know, kind of. Hello.
Yes, sir. You are audible. We are listening to you. Sir.
Okay. नहीं ये screen पता नहीं क्या दिखा रहे हैं आपके screen में.
Expert system in agriculture and man is holding a placard of expert.
Okay. Now somehow mera yahan par I'm not able to see that.
Nahin, kyun sir, usko presentation mode mein jaye na, you will be able to see it.
Nahin, ye pura webex ka screen chala gaya mere yahan se.
So re-login kar dijiye sir, re-login kar dijiye.
Okay. Now it has come. Okay, fine. So what we will do is this is going to be kind of two way. Okay, so initially I will just tell you one thing, a very very crude way of telling what is expert system. So what is expert system? Can somebody tell? I would like first to hear from any one of you. What do you mean by expert system? And it is open to all. So just unmute and tell. Ranjan?
Yes, sir.
Pata hai expert system kya hai? What is expert system?
Yes, sir. It is actually as a app where we can ask our question by either audio, or we can use our photograph to upload there, and then expert will answer, or automatically we can also compare with the answers, sir.
Okay, more or less correct. But basically why we call it an expert system is because see, when you have experts on various aspects, like crop protection, crop production, or you know, fertilizer or irrigation, or this say rice or wheat or onion or tomato, potato, like that, you have different experts and different, but all those experts cannot actually reach to the farmers. Okay, and those who are reaching to the farmers, let us say the State Department, they are not actually the expert in that subject. They are being taught, okay, this is what has to be done. So there is a lot of gap. Okay, so what this platform, as Ranjan has told, does it will make the expert as if the expert is going and reaching to each and every farmers, okay, through this platform. So yes, so that is what basically expert system is. Sashi, you want to say something?
Good morning, sir.
Yeah, good morning.
Myself, Dr. Parvani from Shulini University. Sir, okay. Can we say that expert system is related to the artificial system, is somewhat related to artificial system, artificial intelligence? Can we relate it?
Yeah, yes, you are right. Actually, expert system is also kind of, you know, AI, artificial intelligence. You are correct. It is also kind of artificial intelligence, but a very lower level of artificial intelligence. You are right. That's not sir, wrong in that sense. So can I ask all of you? Yeah.
Sir, one more thing I would like to ask.
Yeah,
sir,
pardon, tell me.
As an expert system, we have all the basic information, like
yes,
to any crop, and that expert has been only been designed to solve the problem of that particular problem. So like it is a kind like where the all the problems are
okay.
inserted in particular section, and the farmer is having that kind of problem. So it is only gives the decision making of that thing.
I think your voice is cracking in between. I'm not able to understand, but what you are trying to say that a particular expert system addresses to only a particular kind of problem. That is it, that?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So actually, see, there are no expert who can solve everything, no, in a real world. So in real world, we have so many experts in different aspects. So similarly, here also we can have different apps or different interfaces whereby experts can reach to the each and every farmer or its users per se. Okay. So now, can I request all of you to kindly open your Rice Expert app?
All
everyone. So it should not be only Parvani who is responding. Others should also be responding to me. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Yes,
sir. So
yes, sir.
Now this is one example that I would like to take you through the session as an expert system. Okay. So now let us understand that what a farmer would like to know from a rice expert. He would like to know about the varieties. He may like to know about the insect pest, disease, nutrients, weeds, you know, non-insect implements, other things. Okay. So this is what Rice Experts is having here. Now, if you go to rice varieties, you know, please click rice varieties, all of you. So you can see there that there are list of upland, specialty rice, Arabic, shallow lowland. These are different conditions or different type of rice for which rice varieties are there. Okay. So there are classification based on classification. They have put the things here. Okay. So now let us go to upland. Okay. So now here you have all the varieties which are there for upland. So from these upland varieties, you can very well go and choose it. So once you choose it, you will come to know that what it is, what is its maturity, what is its yield potential, what type of grain is there, and other things are there. So a farmer would also like to know that what exactly it is. So that is what is given here. And then also we have given some query and feedback mechanism whereby anybody can give the query or feedback to the administrator. Okay. Similarly, you can go back. Even in case of insect pest, you can see. Okay. So different pests are there, and you can say, let us go to the stem borer. So then there are different type of stem borers. So they are asking, you can have say first one only. So it will show the image that this is how it looks like, and you can compare whether your problem, what you are facing, is similar. And accordingly, what to do, how to manage, everything is being given here. Okay. So this is a very, very simple type of expert system that is made. So can I give you 5 minutes or say 5 minutes for you to navigate through other thing and ask me questions if you have on this? Is everyone going through the expert system app?
Yes, sir, we are going through.
Okay, good.
Sir, we are going through.
So if someone of you have gone through it, you can share what you are seeing, or whether you are able to understand what, how they are there and what is in the background.
So hello sir.
Yes.
So I have gone through this one, this recommended insecticides for insect-pesting rice. So yes. I found some of the insecticides are banned already. I mean this time.
Oh, this is old version. This is old version. Let us not discuss, go into that aspect. We are here to see about the export system. Okay.
But this should be rectified.
This has not been revised. Yeah.
So actually, this is a very nice thing, because all the details along with frequently asked questions, how to do management and all is there. So I think it will be as a first-hand opinion, this kind of export systems can really work out.
Yes.
So I also wanted to know, do we have export systems been developed in veterinary science as well, animal science? Because I belong to that stream.
I think Ranjan, can you tell if there are their export systems are there in animal science?
Yeah, sir.
Also there.
I'm Dr. BK just interfering. He can share a number of information, number of systems developed under the domain of veterinary science. And we too at Birsa Agriculture University have separate domain for veterinary expert system. I have already shared the link.
Great.
So
it is there. It is there. Only thing is you have to, you have to go to Play Store and type your desired, keywords, and it will show whether there are there or not. Another thing is, if you go to the ICR website, they have, I think, more than 100 expert systems are there, which is unlisted. So you can also see from there. Okay.
ICR system, actually, I have browsed. So. Okay, sir. Fine. Thank you.
Yeah.
I will share complete information of.
So actually, what actually expert system does, what actually expert system does is, it is a kind of decision support system also, you can say. So it is kind of, suppose for any particular thing, it will be something like a reverse of a tree. Okay, so if you climb a tree, okay, so you climb a tree and then you have different branches, so whichever branch you want to go, you can go. Okay, so now in export system, if I say that I in rice there are, say, five kind of ecosystems, so the upland, lowland, deep water, saline kind of thing. So if my problem is pertaining to, say, lowland, so then I will go to the branch where lowland is written. Okay, and then in lowland, then there are many other things, maybe land preparation, transplanting, this, that. So if I want to go there, then I go there. And then likewise, you can go to the ultimate thing, that what is the fertilizer that I want to apply. So the export system is kind of reverse of a tree. So every leaf is your leaf of a tree is something like the solution to the farmers. You can understand in that way. So that is how you particularly design your export system, whatever you have designing. Okay. So we'll just go by some theory about what it is. Okay. Some definitions are there. The export system is a computer program that possesses knowledge in a particular domain, has the capacity of processing, manipulating, or reasoning with the knowledge with a view to solve a problem, or it expert system may or may not provide the complete expertise or functionality of a human expert, but it must be able to assist the human expert in fast decision making. Okay, so we have some properties. The basic properties of an expert system is it tries to simulate human reasoning capability about a specific domain. That's what I exactly told you, that an expert cannot, reach to every person. But through our expert system, an expert will be reaching through some kind of interface to each and every farmer or each and every extension worker of the country or wherever, you know. And then it performs reasoning over the acquired knowledge rather than merely performing some calculations or performing data retrieval. And it can also, it can solve problems by using heuristic or approximate models. Actually, what you are seeing is the rice expert is very simple kind of expert system. There are many other things also involved. Sometimes there can be an expert system where suppose you can think about an expert system of say designing a building. Okay, so how if you are, have to design a building for somebody, then the parameters are not fixed. There are all this is all different for different users. So they will put in some parameters that what is the size of the land or this and that, and based on that some modeling has to be done, simulation model, and it will give a ultimate result of a house, how it has to be built or something like that. So that can be also some models. So basically what happens is the if you go for the architect of expert system, so generally what happens is your in day-to-day life, experts and users are interacting to each other, okay? But now we, if you have expert system, then the users are using this expert system through user interface. And from experts, what we get is a knowledge acquisition system, you know? What knowledge acquisition system means, whatever knowledge the experts are having, that is collected at one place, okay? So that is a knowledge system that is created, and that knowledge acquisition system will make a knowledge base, okay? And then there will be inference engine which will draw inference from the knowledge. Knowledge by itself does not say something, okay? Suppose if I tell you the example of suppose in case of fertilizer. So how do you know that when you have to apply the fertilizer, you see the color of the leaf, and based on that leaf color, you are applying. So the color of leaf is so many, like you can say there are hundreds of shades of color of leaf, but exactly at which shade you should apply the fertilizer, suppose there is a nutrient problem. So what will be the color of leaf at that stage, or during that, maybe a number of colors will be there in that stage. So that when you get that color, you have to apply the fertilizer. So that kind of inference is also drawn by the expert system. And then there is an explanation subsystem which explains what to do, how to do, you know, things like that. So this is what is the architect of expert system. And I would encourage all of you, at least many of you, should try to develop an expert system of your own field. You know, this is very, very simple thing. Expert system may sound very high, but it is not a very, very tough thing. Okay, so as I told you, the knowledge base, it is actually the vital component of expert system. Okay, it contains facts and heuristic knowledge, and developers try to use the uniform representation of knowledge as far as possible. And there are many knowledge representation schemes, that is like semantic network, you know, frames, propositional logic. Semantic network is like logical network, okay? So you have to use logics in the, representing your knowledge, or rule-based system. So then expert system contains both factual and heuristic knowledge, and factual knowledge is the knowledge of task domain that is widely shared, typically found in textbooks and journals. We have that kind of facts. And heuristic knowledge is less exhaustive, more experiential, and more judgmental knowledge of the performance, what we get from the experiments and other things, you know, that is heuristic knowledge. Then, as I told you, that knowledge acquisition system. Okay, before going to there, so is knowledge base clear to all of you? What is knowledge base? Is knowledge base clear to all of you?
Yes, sir.
Oh, it seems only ladies are enthusiastic in participating. I'm not listening from anyone else. Is it clear? At least some more people should unmute and tell me.
Yes, sir.
No, Ranjan, not you. I would like to listen from those who have not told anything so far.
Yes, sir.
Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Mr. Dr. Gajendra, then tell me what you understand by this. Knowledge acquisition system, what it is?
Sir, it is the expert system who make edge decision support model like in app prepared base. Sir, I am not doctor.
No. You are telling the complete thing. Whatever. No issue. So, somebody else? Gajendra, you have not got it properly. What is knowledge acquisition system or knowledge base?
Good morning, sir.
Someone else? Good morning. Arpita. I think I know, sir. You.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. I also know you. I have listened to
okay.
your lecture.
Yeah, good.
In Northeast, I have listened to your lecture. I have participated in 21 days training. Okay.
Yes, I remember now. Yeah, tell me what it is.
Actually, sir, expert system is a computer-based system, as you told us.
No. I'm not talking about expert system. Arpita, about expert system. Just knowledge acquisition system. What is that? What do you understand by that?
Type of knowledge that is a factual knowledge or heuristic knowledge and knowledge based system that we have to collect the content from the different type of sources, and this is related to our cognitive part.
Very good. Sir. Correct. Exactly correct. So this is basically related to cognitive part. So whatever knowledge is there regarding some particular aspects on which you are developing an expert system, you need to collect all those knowledge. So that is what knowledge acquisition system does. Good, very good. I am happy. So my old students are doing well, it seems. Okay. So so this is what is knowledge acquisition system. Okay. Then we have inference engine. So as I told you, that inference engine is used to perform reasoning with both the expert knowledge, which is extracted from the expert, and data, which is specific to the problem being solved. So in many of the expert system, sometimes they will ask you to feed in some data. You give this data, that data. So that thing, as well as whatever expert knowledge is there, they both are processed and some inferences drawn by that. So that is what is the work of the inference engine. Okay. So inference engine tries to derive answers from knowledge base. It's the brain of expert system, as it is told, that provides that methodology for reasoning about the information in the knowledge base and for formulating conclusions. And then user interface, I think all of you understand what exactly user interface is. What you have just seen in your app, Rice Expert, that is user interface. What is there in front of the user? So what is there in the background is not coming into the picture. Only what is there in the front is coming to the picture. So it enables the users to communicate with the expert system. Okay. Then, there are many things, forward chaining, backward chaining. These are the mechanism that goes in reasoning for inference, drawing inference. So sometimes forward chaining is like from data, you go to the conclusions, or sometimes it is also done the reverse way. You come to the particular conclusion, and for which what kind of data is required, that is being calculated. Then explanation subsystem is there, which allows the program to explain its reasoning to the user, and the explanation can range from how the final or intermediate solutions were arrived at to justify the need of additional data, So then we have some applications of expert system, particularly in decision making in agriculture field, which we all know many places, medical diagnosis also, it is being used. Then industrial and commercial problems, it is being used. and then process monitoring and control is also there. Financial decision making also it is there. Knowledge publishing, planning and scheduling. Okay, so these are the kind of applications that we see in general. Then these are some examples that I have taken. RISE experts that we are already, you know, thing. So then what are the advantages that is there in expert system? Actually, it enhances the decision quality. Okay, so as you know that all the experts cannot reach to every place. So when this expert system is there, then it will certainly help the users to enhance its decision quality. And then it provides quick and efficient solution to the problems in narrow down the area of specialization. Also, you can tell that it is highly reliable as it is based on the knowledge of the experts. Okay, and then it can tackle very complex problems that are difficult for human experts to solve, because expert system is not just the knowledge base, but also many a kind of some models are there which will calculate things for the users. So humanly it may not be possible to calculate sometimes some simulation models and other things, but otherwise this expert system will certainly, you know, help in solving the complex problems. But there are also limitations. Okay, so the limitation is the knowledge base may not be complete. If you don't have a complete set of knowledge base, then your expert system may not be able to solve, you know, each and every problem of the user. Then each problem has different solution, so it may differ from expert to expert. That also we know. So sometimes you may be giving some kind of uniform solution, which may not be so much location specific, unless you have designed your expert system in that way, that location specific solutions are being given. And then it adheres to only specific domain, which is obviously it is there. Then it requires constant manual updates. Like one of our participants, he told that some of the insecticide is banned. So that is what has happened, that after the expert system, if you don't update it, then something like this will come into the picture. Then expensive to build and maintain. It takes long time to develop and fine tune the expert system, and large expert system is difficult to build and maintain. We can't have a very, very large expert system. Like if you want to develop an expert system for each and every commodity in agriculture, so you can't have a single expert system for that. So it will be difficult to make something like that. So till now, is it okay? Or some explanation, more explanation is required by you? Have I gone very fast through the slides?
No, sir, it's fine.
Okay, sir.
Sir, I
so,
want
so
to.
If any expl.
So one question, sir. Like as you said, an individual can also build up an expert system on its own on any commodity on which he or she likes.
Yes.
So once we have made an app on it, on an expert on any crop, so like, do we need to get registered with any of an organization, or like, what is the next step towards it?
Okay. See, from our point of view, yeah, this is Parvani. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for opening this question. This is very interesting question. See, first of all, what you have to do is you have to develop a systematic knowledge how it is going to be, you know, kind of delivered to the users. So that aspect table work, you have to first do it. Okay. Ooh. So as I told you, you know, it is the reverse of a tree. Okay,
yeah.
If you put a tree, suppose your what is your commodity of interest? Can you tell me so that it will become interesting for you?
Sir, for example, I want like do on apple.
because
Apple.
as like
good fine
yeah
fine good so now you can go for Apple okay so first of all if you go for Apple then what is the first thing that a farmer or whoever is you know orchard owner he faces what exactly he where from he starts suppose if I want to start my apple orchard where from mm-hmm. I start
sir first of all he like he will be searching for like a proper way from where he can have like easily maintenance or what else
site selection you are saying
selection yeah he has his
site
own
selection okay fine good enough so you have to actually get your data or your knowledge about site selection so one of the aspect of your expert system will be like site selection and okay. then what are the parameters that one has to look into site selection you know
very near to the house
whatever so you have to mention all those parameters whether you have this parameter okay if they don't have then what are the minimum parameters that one has is okay with is okay. Okay, so that is one thing. Second thing is once he has that, then how to prepare the land for the orchard?
Yeah.
Okay, so mm-hmm. you have to have another aspect is land preparation.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so in land yeah. preparation again, you have to tell him that how that land is being prepared, what are mm-hmm. the implements being used. What mm-hmm. is the design or layout of the land for orchard? How okay. much the distance will be there? Mm-hmm. If he or she is using, you know, like in apple, you have different type of varieties. No, some are very short, not that yes. big, very short.
Yes.
So what kind of variety? So based on that, those varieties, what will mm-hmm. be the design of the orchard? Means
yeah.
plant to plant and row to row, all kind of thing. I don't know whether that holds true in case of apple or not. But
so
that
kind
is, of thing.
Yeah. Okay. So but in orchard, sir, the farmers face one kind of problem is a problem of the pruning, because the farmers like
okay.
every farmer doesn't get the proper training on it. So like
yes,
they are not, and very much farmers are not aware that when correct time for the pruning. So
yes,
can it be that included in that export system in
yes.
the, that
see code? now you have two things okay now mm-hmm. here you have I think we are making the session very interesting now yeah. here you have two things okay one thing is why one should go for
Hello?
Training pruning yes are you not able to listen to me
hi
Hello, Parvani, you are able to listen to me? Basan, am I audible?
Sir, you are audible.
Yes, sir.
No, I think some problem with Parvani. It seems.
No, you are audible, sir. You are audible.
Because the question was from Parvani, so I would like to know whether she is able to listen to me or not. Parvani, am I audible to you? She is off. Anyway, for others, I can tell you. Maybe once she joins, she can ask again. Okay, she is having some network issue. So what we have to do is, suppose how to prune. Is you want to do that can be done in two or three ways. One is you can write about how to prune. Second is you can even insert some short videos in your expert system, you know, so that the users can see how exactly it is being pruned. So that can also become part of your expert system. Okay, so I think I answered to her. Any other persons who would like to ask? Question regarding their interest. Parvani, we are not able to listen to you.
Hello.
Parvani, I think you are there was some problem with you.
Yeah, it's not a session.
Hello. Okay. So anyone else would like to say ask something? Okay, Basant, probably people
sir,
are interested to ask it since.
Hello, sir. Hello.
Yes.
I have one question, sir. What is the difference between this mobile app and expert system?
Mobile app, see, it is only an interface of expert system. Okay. What, the expert system can also be, you know, kind of a website. It can also be some other thing. Okay. App is just one interface for sharing the expert knowledge. It is nothing more than that. You can't say there are not two different things. It is part of the expert system's extension to you, you know. So through yes, app, you understand this. Okay. So yes. Now I would like all of you to again go back to the rice expert, and then you can see there is fertilizer calculator. And if you can just go into that. Have you gone to that fertilizer calculator? Now everybody, yes, once you come to that calculator, you can select the rice ecology, because ecology wise fertilizer is different, you know. So now I have like gone for irrigated kharif. So it says 80-40-40 NPK is 80-40-40, or else I can choose my own. Suppose as a farmer, I don't want to apply 80-40-40, I want to apply more than that or less than that, then I can also choose my own dose. Okay, so based then, yes, so again you can see that there is like stage of application. You have to fill that, whether it is the basal. Suppose I choose that it is a basal. Okay, and then what is the area that we have. So if I say 12 acres, okay. And if we submit, okay. 80-40-40. Do it. I don't know, there is some problem in my case. Could you get something there? Anyway, forget it.
It's coming, sir.
I think I'm
It is coming, sir.
Coming?
But yes, sir.
No, in my case, it has not come. Something wrong. I'm doing.
Actually,
I don't know.
Actually, in Basel also, it is showing that half dose, 1/4 dose, or 1/3 dose. It is asking stage of application also.
Yeah, that also I have given, but somehow, why it is not showing?
I can make in Gunther, sir. It is totally better, sir.
Whatever, it should not be
yes, sir.
problem. Acha. Gunto it is giving. Okay. So you can actually there is some problem with Acre. Anyway, so it is giving accordingly. Now I want you to understand this, that behind that there is some mathematical calculation going on, you know, to get this answer. So if farmer does not know how much he has to apply the fertilizer, he can very well go and give these parameters data. And I have, you know, I have given you earlier also that it's not that all the knowledge, every solution will come from the knowledge of the experts, but sometimes some data has to be fed in and that is being processed, and then you get the answer for that. Okay, so I wanted to just show you this. There is some issue with my slides. Anyway, so what is happening is, suppose in case of your crop is affected by blast disease, you have to take the following measures to control. Please mix this many grams of triclosan and all these things, and this many water and all. So in the background, what you are seeing is in red. So these formulas are being used in the app. So based on that, it will give the answers, you know, because we know that what is the dose and what, how it has to be mixed. So these things are there with us as an expert knowledge. So using that, you can make it available to the expert users, you know. Similarly, something like as simple as like roguing. So what is roguing? In that roguing, you don't have many calculations. So the only thing is when roguing can be done. So we have to answer like roguing can be done in various stages. Then we are showing those stages where roguing can be done in case of seed production of paddy, and what exactly it is, off type and other things, stubbles have to be removed. These things are also put in the expert system. So here I end. Any questions, any more explanations that you want to ask?
Sir, I want to know that whether the precision farming or that expert system is same, or the expert system is to support the precision farming.
Precision farming and expert system are very different things. Okay. In precision farming, what is happening is basically, see, the precision farming, if you are doing, you may be doing, say, for 1 hectare of land, you are doing the precision farming. Okay, so now there you have different type of sensors which will see whether, suppose in case of precision farming, we want to control the irrigation. Okay, so what will happen is you have moisture meter in the soil, which will check whether the soil is having sufficient water or not. The moment the soil will not be having sufficient water, the sensor will sense it and it will give indication to the sprinkler system or whatever irrigation system to start it. Okay, so that kind of thing is there in the precision farming. And the for precision farming, whatever system you develop is there for a particular spot. It's not going to different people. Everyone has to have their own precision farming. It's not expert system. Okay, so it is basically
the help of that expert system to decide whether the how much the water requirement is there. That can be decided by the expert system. Is it possible?
See, in precision farming also you are using decision support system, that I agree with you. But it is not basically an expert system. Okay, here the decisions are taken by machines, you know, artificial intelligence is being used. It is kind of automated. So in precision farming, all your fertilizer, water, and other things are used up to precise quantity. Okay, but suppose some disease has occurred in your precision farming. I don't think your precision farming will provide you solution for that. Okay.
Yes, that's why, sir, I am that expert system will be useful for that precision farming. We can enhance the productivity of that precision farming. That expert
yes,
system.
Yes, that way what you are saying is correct. Yeah. Yeah, that way what you are saying is correct. We can also think in that one step ahead, that whether expert system can also be integrated with precision farming, that may be possible. We can think about that. Okay.
Abhar sir.
Dr. Singh.
Abhar sir.
Ah.
Yeah, come with your video because I'm recording it. And the presentation should not go without your video.
Okay. Okay. Actually, I was at home, so I thought that maybe I will skip my video.
Now you are visible. Now, participants, you can have discussion because presentation is already over. So we can have discussion. I think.
So let everyone have their videos on.
Okay, sir.
Vasant, let everyone have their video.
Yeah, yes,
so
surely.
That you can have screenshots.
To come with your video.
Okay, meanwhile, we can take more questions.
What about the development cost, sir?
Cost of developing, this may vary based on, you know, what is the complexity of your expert system. Like the apps that we have developed at NRRI has cost around 1 lakh rupees, but it can also go into many lakhs. Suppose there is something like simulation or something. So I don't know, it can be also 50 lakhs. You never know. Yes.
Yeah. Sir, my suggestion anything? Is that, yeah. You are working in some commodity organization like rice. So your domain is fixed, but at university level, an extension scientist or chemical scientist has to work with so many commodities. So the question is right that they should include a number of enterprises, number of commodities, so that they could be able to cater to the needs of different category of farmers. So,
Who asked that question? I have not got that question.
सर मेरा एक सवाल है सर
वाज देयर अ क्वेश्चन लाइक दैट हां
दैट वाज सॉल्यूशन
सर
हां शशि पूछिए
हां सर कितना इफेक्टिवनेस है सर एक्सपर्ट सिस्टम का कितना यूज हो रहा इस पर कुछ सर्वे हुआ सर
ओके ओके या इट इज देयर एक्चुअली इफ आई टेल यू अबाउट द the question is like how much is if expert system effective and whether it is being used. So I think it is there, and even rice expert system is not only used in India but also used in many other countries. So many African countries, many Asian countries are using our rice expert system. So once you develop, you also will have to popularize it. So I agree with Shashi that it's not that you just develop an expert system and then people are there to use it. You have to also popularize. And coming to Basant, your question that KVK people are having many commodities, so they should have a system where many commodities are there in one place. So instead of that, what we can have is we can have an interface for going to different expert system. So that will make their job easier.
Sir,
okay.
In the field, we are deciding that fertilizer dose, whether it is possible to decide without the soil analysis in the expert system.
Without soil analysis?
Yes, sir.
Yes, yes. This is good, Dr. Singh. You have asked a very good question. We also have one expert system which is called Rice N Expert. Okay. So this N Expert is basically taking, what you have to do is here the farmer has to take the photograph of the leaf, four or five photographs of the leaf, and then he has to just the expert system, it matches with the library of the photographs that it has, and then it tells whether how much is deficiency and how much fertilizer you have to use. So that kind of app is also there. You can download Rice N Expert. Okay, so now there artificial intelligence is being used in that particular thing. So in the background, we have a library of photographs of leaf of rice at different stages. And then based on the library, automatically the system matches it. Okay, the farmer's photograph as well as the photograph that is available in our library. And in library, we know if this is the color, what is the, how much is the deficiency and how much fertilizer is to be added. So that is being done. Okay. So there, without any soil analysis, the farmer can know about how much fertilizer to add.
Sir, I have a submission.
We have 67 participants. I should be getting more questions.
Sir, I have a submission. Actually, what happens that most of many of the means district officers or block level officers, actually many of them are not even aware of these apps. So as Basant sir pointed out, actually there should be need of more means awareness camps about these things.
That is true. That is true. That's true. Ah, Ranjay. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Ranjay Singh, आप कुछ पूछ रहे हैं?
Hello, sir.
Hello.
Am I audible? I'm Anna.
So, Basant, is yeah? Yes. Anna Raj, yes, please ask.
Hello, sir. Can I ask my question? Sir.
Yeah, please.
Expression scientist, how to start with the entire process of expert system development? What things we have to start first? How to initiate the entire process?
You will have to kindly come again because you are not audible.
Sir,
yeah.
Type your question. Yeah. You are audible now.
Sir, I have typed my question already. It's in your inbox, yes. I feel. In your chat box.
Yeah. How to collect information to design an expert system. Proceed to entire process. Okay. See, basically, when we as an extension scientist, we have a lot of advantage. The advantage with us is we exactly know what are the questions that is being asked by farmers, okay, about a particular commodity. So what are their problems in that particular area, that we know. So you can design the structure of the expert system, that what are the aspects, and within each aspect, what are the sub aspects of every aspect, okay. So accordingly, you have to first make a design like a tree, okay, reverse of the tree. And once you get all those aspects, then you have to consult the expert in that that particular aspects of everything. Because see, suppose if I take an example of rice, rice has got production export, we require protection exports, we require irrigation water export, we require fertilizer export, we require different type of disease and different insects, because that is being studied by different people. Not that all the disease, all the insects are being studied by the same expert. So then you have to go to different experts, collect information about that, and then you create that your knowledge base. Okay, that is what is knowledge acquisition system is there. Okay, and once you have this knowledge and everything with you, then you will have to go to the developer, some developer who will write code for you for app development. Okay. Is it okay?
Sir, yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Yeah. So, Prasant, it seems if there are no questions, then we can call it a day. Or
yes, sir. Yeah, very nice and interactive lecture, sir. Because you just excited our participants.
Hello.
Many of them are from agriculture background, and when we call IT expert as a resource person, they take less interest. I wouldn't say least interest. They take less interest because they cannot come down to our level. Some technicalities are there. Because I have invited at least 10 IT experts from CDAC, different CDACs, mostly senior directors. They had their presentations were good, but they could not invite questions. So, sir, in that respect, I must give you heartfelt thanks that you could motivate our participants and could invite a lot of questions. And until unless they ask questions, they cannot clarify themselves. Okay, sir. Thank you. Thank you very much for being with us. And on behalf of participants and organizing committee, I again
thank you. And another thing is, I actually you can give my details, email and phone number, just in case anybody wants to develop an app expert system, they can contact me. I'll be happy to give inputs from my side.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Namaskar, sir.